Good day, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome to West Coast Paper Mills Limited Q4 and FY21 earnings conference call. As a reminder, all participant lines will be in listen-only mode, and there will be an opportunity for you to ask questions after the presentation concludes. Should you need assistance during the conference call, please signal an operator by pressing star, then zero on your touchtone phone. Please note that this conference is being recorded. I now hand the conference over to Mr. Navin Agrawal, Head Institutional Equities at SKP Securities Limited. Thank you, and over to you, sir.
Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. On behalf of all of us at SKP Securities, it is my great pleasure and privilege to welcome you to this financial results conference of West Coast Paper Mills Limited. We have with us Mr. S.K. Banga, Chairperson and Managing Director, along with his colleagues, Mr. Jain, Executive Director and CFO, Mr. Rajesh Bothra, Vice President, Corporate Finance, and Mr. S.K. Khemani, Vice President, Corporate. We will have the opening remarks from Mr. Banga, following which we'll open the floor for a quick Q&A session. Thank you, and over to you, Mr. Banga.
Thank you, Mr. Agrawal. I am S.K. Banga, CMD, West Coast Paper. I would like to thank SKP Securities for organizing this interactive session. I will welcome all the participants for this interactive session. Firstly, I will give a small background of the company. I think most of you must be knowing a bit, but okay, again, I will give a very short synopsis. West Coast is a pulp-based paper company in south of India, that is near Hubli, near Belgaum. We made a major expansion 10 years before, involving around more than 1,400 crores that time. We did a very out of the situation technology, and the plant is now working very nicely. All our product qualities are very, very stable, and they are having their own ranking in the domestic market. Now, we took over Andhra Paper. West Coast Paper took over Andhra Paper last November 2019, and West Coast raised a loan of around 800 crores just to take over Andhra Paper. And as on date, our total loan in the company is around 650 crores, including working capital. This 650 crore rupees includes our 100 crore rupees sales tax loan, which is interest-free, and this is to be repaid in 7-8 years' time from now. So in that way, our debt equity is very comfortable, and our total loan, as I told you, stands, including working capital, around 650 crore. West Coast have been paying dividend regularly from last 20 years. In a span of 20 years, we skipped dividend only once. And from last three to four years, we have been paying good reward to our shareholders, and our dividend percentage are more than 250% from last four years. After this expansion of 1,000+ crore, we have taken a build program also of our all existing machines. And all our major build program has come to shape now. And now, this year onwards, means 2021, 2022 year onwards, we don't have any major build program in our end, as we have completed all our programs, which we are required to make our production quality based and cost based. Now I will come to this year's result. As we all know, that country is facing a very delicate situation on the COVID front, and paper companies have been one of the worst affected. And in that also, West Coast had been quite severely affected, because our segment, 30% of our production is on the writing and printing base, that is educational sector base. So one has been a very big demand constant from last 9 to 12 months. And second have been our disruption in the production level also because of the COVID. In many of our sections, there were high number of COVID cases, which had affected our production activity also. Now the company has come to a normal level from the month of June. And from 15th of June onwards, the situation has become normal on the production front. If we talk about last year, last three quarters have been pretty bad in view of the COVID situation. Last three quarters have been negative in our operation. Last quarter of the last financial year, that is January, March, had a practical normalcy in the operation, and we saw a cash profit of around 130 crores in last quarter, and our net profit was somewhere in the range of I think 90 crores or something. So January, February, March have been to a normal level. Now April, May, June again have been affected. April was not so bad, but it was affected. May was very severely affected. June was also affected, but from 15 June onwards, we are finding improvement in the market demand also, and our dispatches also. So we hope that maybe by 15th of July, situation will be further improving. And once the education sector and court and offices open, our main 30% product, which is getting affected, would come to a normal level maybe by July and maybe August. So this has been mainly, as I was just saying, nothing on the production level, nothing on the mechanical level or the personal level, not on the labor account, just because of the COVID, market has been affected, personnel has been affected, and which has ultimately resulted in our financial performances. So as I was just saying, that from July first week, we expect the normalcy to come in the prices also at the personal level also. Now I would like to add that, okay, as I was saying, that all our major upgradation program of the existing machines, existing factory has been taken. Now we have got a program to go for a new machine. We have got the environment clearance. Some of the formalities at the environment level is there. Maybe in a month or two, we will be getting all the environment clearances for our new further addition of capacity. This license, this clearance from the MOEF, we are getting to the range of roughly 1,35,000 tons roughly. So we would be adding one machine of 1 lakh plus ton, and some improvement we will be doing in our existing machines also. So with the new machine and the upgradation of our existing machine a bit, we hope that maybe we will be able to come to this enhanced capacity of further 1,30,000 tons. which is yet to be taken up, and we will be taking up this activity once we get all the MOEF clearances. So I think this is a very short synopsis of the whole scene. I will just like to add here again that our production, 30% we are having, as I was saying, our writing and printing varieties, which is called educational and office varieties. 30% we call it copier, which is a photocopy paper. And 30% we have bought other varieties like cup stock and other industrial varieties. So this depends our whole capacity. So now I think this is a very, very brief scene of the company. Now, whatever are the questions, we will be happy to answer you. And our ED, Mr. Jain, is also with us. So maybe he will be also able to clarify many of the points. So now the floor is open from our side. And Naveen, I think now you can take over.
Should I open the floor for Q&A, sir?
Yes, sir.
Thank you very much. We will now begin the question and answer session. Anyone who wishes to ask a question may press star and one on their touchtone telephone. If you wish to remove yourself from the question queue, you may press star and two. Participants are requested to use handsets while asking a question. Ladies and gentlemen, we will wait for a moment while the question queue assembles. The first question is from the line of Sudarshan Padmanabhan from Sundaram Mutual Fund. Please go ahead.
Yeah, thank you for taking my question. Sir, my question is, what has happened. I mean, we have seen the major hit, you know, specifically with writing and paper, you know, completely because of the lockdown, etc. Now with lockdown opening, and, you know, what we are also hearing is that schools should eventually open, which is a big business for us. Can you give us some color with respect to how do you see the, reversal happening with respect to what happened, from, FY21 to probably when we move towards FY22?
One thing, should all the questions, or we should go one by one? Should we take the question and answer, or we take all the questions and then we answer in one go?
Sir, the second question from my side is, yeah. I mean, whichever way it is, sir. I mean, whatever it is comfortable with you, sir.
Okay.
The second question from my side is, we are one of the very few players who don't depend too much on pulp, external pulp. So, I mean, in this scenario where we are hearing that pulp prices can be volatile and moving up, I mean, should it be right for me to assume that players who have more captive access should benefit more as compared to players who do not have captive access to pulp? And the third question and the final question from my side is, what is our, thought process in amalgamating with Andhra? So when is it expected, and do we think that that should be the way forward to think about? These are the three questions from my side, sir.
Okay. First thing is reversal. We hope that once the things start from July 2nd week or maybe July 3rd week, this lockdown scene, reversal should be quite fast, because there is no stock and the printing activity would be going in full bloom. So maybe in a month's time, the scene would be very, very different what we are seeing now. Prices will be definitely going up. And there are not major players are there who are to add to the supplies. So we hope that both the companies, West Coast and Andhra, both will be benefited once there is some normalcy on the lockdown front.
And sir, inventory should not be much on the channel, right? I mean, we should benefit on the primary sales itself completely.
No, the inventory, abhi hum log ke paas, there is inventory. But this inventory, we hope that we had a very high inventory in January when we started. And that the entire inventory was liquidated in 1.5 months time, and we came to a very, very nominal level of 3-4 days of production, 5 days of production of inventory at the end of March. If you see our inventory level at the end of March, it was very, very low inventory. It was a very, very normal inventory. So now inventory level is quite high as on this date. But as I was saying that from last 1 week, we are seeing a good improvement in the dispatches. And this trend continues, and we hope to even improve the things in next week. So I hope that maybe by 1.5 months, July, August 15 to August end, inventory levels will be again to a very, very low level. So we are quite confident that this should happen in 1.5 time, in 6 weeks to 8 weeks time.
Sure, sir.
And another question was about the captive pulp, the advantage. You are absolutely right. People who are having the pulp production would be definitely benefited. And the pulp prices are now, of course, very high internationally. Even if they come down a bit, they won't be affecting the advantages with the captive pulp people would be having.
Mm-hmm.
So we hope that situation should be and now Mr. Jenny also there, he can also confirm in his scene that our pulp production we have improved with this upgradation from last 2 months. But the advantage we couldn't see because of this lockdown and because of our plant was not working full. So our with this improvement in the pulp system, we hope to go for 95 to 98% of our own pulp consumption. So definitely the people who are having their own pulp production will be getting their reward. Then
but have the prices talking of paper moved up, sir, because of the prices of pulp? So we will basically benefit from higher spread.
No, the price improvement in the paper front is not much there. Because this COVID situation in local demand, even in the international scene, the COVID is affected in many of the African countries and many of other countries. So we hope that maybe situation should be improving all around, maybe in a month or 2 months time, because this COVID scene is now coming in control in various countries. So with this happening, prices should improve internationally also and locally also. And could be whatever price we have seen earlier in last year, it may be even crossing or improving on our earlier realization of average price.
Mm-hmm. Sure, sir.
Your third point was Andhra and WCPM merger. Merger scene, we were working on this, but because of the COVID, we couldn't come to a very clear conclusion. We have given this assignment to some professionals, and they also couldn't visit the plant, see both the plants. So this exercise is just yet to come to a final shape. We hope that maybe we will be more clear on about this merger sale. What is the advantage? What is the neutral thing? What is disadvantage? So all these comprehensive thing we hope to get in some time, and only then we can come to a final decision. Okay, in what if we have to merge, and if we have to merge, when we have to merge.
Okay.
So let this clarity should be coming from the outside people, from the experts. Then we will take a final call in this.
Sure, sir. Thanks a lot, sir.
Thank you.
Mr. Bangur, just an update. We can answer one question at a time and accordingly move to the next question.
Okay. Right.
Thank you. The next question is from the line of Nitesh Shah from Equitas Investments. Please go ahead.
Good afternoon, sir. Sir, I wanted to understand the CAPEX part you said. So where are we planning to expand?
Pardon? Can you come again?
Sir, you said that we are planning a new machine. 1,35,000 tons. In which particular segment are we planning to expand this?
This new machine will not be in the writing and printing segment. This will be in the packaging side only. We had got the permission for our tissue machine expansion, but we thought that tissue will not be so exciting. So we requested again the MOEF to study and give us the permission for writing and for packaging paper. So again we have made a request, so they have given us the clearance, and this expansion would be on the packaging sector only.
Okay. And sir, how much time will it take for the capacity?
Once we get all the clearances, because as per the law, we cannot do anything until we get all the government clearances. So if we hope to get all the government clearances, maybe in 3-4 months time, and then it will take, we will start the process, it will take not less than 18 months to 20 months.
Okay. And where is this coming up?
Yeah, it will be in the same site, Dandeli, near our existing site.
Oh, okay. And sir, any amount? I mean, if you have...
Amount we have not yet calculated, but anything you plan now, if a new machine is there, it will be definitely not less than 500 to 700 crores. So those details we don't know till now, because we are getting all the details, but normally if you go for a second-hand machine, it will be much lesser. But we would prefer to go for a new machine, which will be somewhere in this range only. The entire project cost will not be less than 500 crores to 700 crores.
Okay. And sir, currently, how is the demand scenario for the packaging board and the pricing?
Packaging board is doing good. And again, in packaging segment also, there are very, very low-end varieties, high-end varieties, super high-end, super high-end varieties. So there are many segments in the packaging. So we are planning, because we have got the capacity, there is a limitation on our production capacity. So we are planning for a high-end packaging. So that demand is there, it is growing also. So there will be flexibility in our machine selection, but we are planning for a higher-end packaging only.
Okay. And sir, currently how much capacity do we have for this?
The sanction would be 1,30,000 for that.
Oh.
1,30,000. The MOEF clearance would be for 1,30,000.
Okay. So currently how much capacity do we have for this?
Now our total production is 3,20,000.
And for packaging in that?
It's a packaging, we don't have packaging.
Okay, so this would be a new product line for us.
We don't have any packaging. We have got duplex board, which is a low-end packaging, but this level of packaging we are not having now. We are having packaging of very low grade, means medium grade or maybe low grade packaging.
Okay, sir. Thank you so much.
Okay, thank you. Thank you, Mr. Sasa.
Thank you. The next question is from the line of Govind Lal Gilada, an individual investor. Please go ahead.
Good afternoon, Bangarji and ESCO's team. Very thanks for conducting this call, and I hope this for every future also, after all results, you will be continuing these calls. So I have got some few questions, sir. So first, I want to know volume for full year and fourth quarter.
Jaji, volume what?
Fourth quarter or full year ke liye kya volume tha?
Production. Achha, fourth quarter ka also volume ka production volume kya?
Fourth or full year or fourth quarter?
Fourth quarter ka and full year ka. Okay, okay.
Govindji, I will answer this question. Volume for the West Coast for the full year, it was 2,29,000.
Can you give console or you are giving for West Coast only, sir?
No, I am giving for West Coast only.
Okay. West Coast. Here is Mr. Jain, our ED.
Thank you, sir. Fourth quarter, how much you told, sir, West Coast?
With the fourth quarter, the production was 81,000.
Okay. And sales?
For the full year, it was 2,34,000. And so for the fourth quarter
was how much?
1,01,000.
1,01,000. And full year production and sales?
Full year production, Govindji, 2,29,000 was a production, and sales are 2,34,000.
2,34,000. Thank you. That is very helpful. Then coming to our finance cost this quarter, how it has substantially gone down, sir, finance cost?
Govindji, in this what has happened, we have taken the Euro loan, Euro ECB loan. So there's a rate difference in this exchange rate actually. The exchange rate as on 31st March, it has come down. The impact is around 9 crore actually. So because of that reason, the interest cost has gone down in totality.
Okay, so in future we hope to have same kind of finance cost, sir, or it will be?
No, Govindji. It depends because this is accounting entry which we have to take, exchange rate variations which we have to take. So in case it goes up, then there will be impact actually.
Okay. Followed, sir. Then about our tax rate, sir, it is totally confusing. Full year, quarter on quarter, sometimes we get credit tax rates, sometimes. So what should we take, sir, tax rate for whole year going forward?
Actually, what has happened in this, since we had a negative earning, so for the first three quarter, that we had considered, and then the fourth quarter we did very well. So because of that, we have to take account for that. But in totality, it was not working out after considering the previous income tax adjustments. So that we have not considered actually. So it is a Govindji, this year it is a altogether abnormal thing actually.
No, followed, but in last few years also I am not able to understand. Generally, okay, let us leave aside this year and going forward, no, what will be the tax rate, sir?
Actually, we are like, we have a deferred, because you may be seeing there's a deferred tax entries that which has coming because we have to take the provision as for income tax as those entries are coming. And we have other income tax benefits in our income tax return. So we are claiming. So if you see the something last year, it was working out around 17% the tax rate was coming actually.
So that what I want to know, sir, this year or next year, how much tax rate should be? Generally, other JK paper, all that, they are providing some 27, 28, 30%. So what kind of tax rate we will be having this year and next year?
We will be having the lower. As I mentioned to you that in our income tax return, there are certain benefits are there which we are claiming. So because of that, we will be having a lower tax actually.
So lower, can you specify number? How much is
it? It should be in the same range as I told you, Govindji. Last year it was 17%. So more or less in the same range it should come actually.
So this beneficial interest rate 17, okay. When we'll come back to normal rate, sir? How long this?
It will take another two, three years time actually.
Okay. 2-3 years we can have 17-18%, then it will be normal rate. Then what is our average realization, sir, for full year and fourth quarter?
Govindji, what has happened, the realization part, it has come down actually. Because Chairman, sir, you would like to answer this?
I think March, last year, roughly 64,000 or like.
No, I want for then, last full year and fourth quarter. So.
If you take that, Govindji, if you are saying for the full year, it is working out 55,000.
Okay.
And in the March, it is working out at the more or less 54,000 actually.
54,000 for March quarter also.
Haji, haji.
What this other income, sir? What is it? Last year we had other income of some 48 crores, and then last year we had only 10 crores. So why this difference of almost 30 crores in other income, sir?
Actually, in other income, what happened last year, we had a funds and we made the investment because we had planned for the acquisition of Andhra Paper. So when we liquidated those investment, so whatever the income we got, that we had accounted there, and this year it is not there. So the normal other income is in the range of 2 to 3 crores actually.
And this our consolidated result includes our share of AP paper, no sir? 11.34 EPS, and standalone we are showing 8.27, and the consolidated is 11.34. This incremental EPS is from AP paper, no sir? That is
You
have got some 70% share, no sir, in AP paper?
72% share actually.
Also, this EPS is coming to some 3 rupees between difference standalone and consol. And AP paper first quarter has shown, I think, around 8 rupees EPS. So 70 comes 8, 7, it should be some 5, 6 rupees EPS. So where I am missing, sir, something?
No, I was not able to understand your question actually.
No, AP paper standalone results have come, no sir, a few days back. That time AP paper has shown 8 rupees EPS. We have got 72% we are telling. So 8, 7, it should be around 55 rupees plus EPS should be added to console. So our console result, standalone 8.27 EPS is there, and console 11.34, only 3 rupees has been added. That's what I want to understand. It should be 5 rupees tentative when we calculate 72% of the AP paper standalone result.
I have to just check the calculation, what you are saying, how it is to come. Because what my finance team has prepared, it's 11.34 and it has been audited, verified by the auditors also. So,
Govindaji, can I suggest one thing? Let Mr. Jain understand and then he will give you the figure maybe tomorrow or day after. Because if he is not able to give right immediately.
Okay, sir. Thank you very much.
Jain ji, you have to number leke and communicate kar dena.
ठीक है
थैंक यू सर बहुत बहुत धन्यवाद बांगड़ जी और मैं उम्मीद करता हूँ एक कॉल आगे भी करेंगे आप
नहीं नहीं जी वी आर ट्राइंग टू दैट इज दैट वे ओनली एंड आप लोगों को भी इंटरेस्ट आ रहा है हमको भी लगता है कि एक इन्वेस्टर्स के हिसाब से एक आपस का इंटरेक्शन होना भी चाहिए तो वी होप टू कंटिन्यू वी विल डेफिनेटली कीप इट ऑन
Yeah, sir. Every small companies, your market cap is almost around 1600-1700 crores. Abhi toh 2-400 crore ki company abhi call karti hai. So this is the only opportunity once in 3 months we get to clarify so many. Otherwise, we will be under confusion. So many things, it gives opportunity to clarify also. And the management will also come to know the thought process of investors, what they want to understand, all that. So I appreciate, sir. And I hope this process will be continued.
Thanks for the advice. I think we will just keep in mind.
Thank you. The next question is from the line of P. Sajdev from Albatross Capital. Please go ahead.
Yeah, good afternoon, sir. So just a point on the export opportunity, you know, with the imports being virtually zero and, you know, pulp prices globally being very high, any comments on the export opportunity for the company?
We are trying our export. We are working on this. We were not doing much of export, but as the scenes are happening in the country, we are trying to increase our exports. We were having very, very nominal export in our West Coast company. So maybe it will take 3 months to 6 months time to come to a minimum level of export. So we are working on this. Normally the export prices are lower than the domestic prices. So we were not very much for the export. But now we feel that looking to the various advantages in long term, we are planning to shift some of our percentage to the export. So we are working on it. We have no export, we normally export it. But I think we are working on it.
Right. So, I just had a suggestion, you know, instead of, you know, asking and, you know, answering questions on production, sales, realization, if you could just come out with a presentation before the quarterly call, you know, it'll help save time. And we can focus more on, you know, fundamentals and question related to the sector.
Okay.
Thanks.
Yeah, आपका सजेशन ठीक है, विल कीप इन माइंड एंड सी कि कैसे इसको हम लोग शेप में लाएं या कैसे इसको इंप्लीमेंट कर सकते हैं।
Mr. Sajdev, you have any more questions? We move to the next question from the line of Shivaji Mehta, an individual investor. Please go ahead.
Sir, thank you for this opportunity. Sir, I just wanted to clarify one thing. Basically, on the pulp prices. So globally, the pulp prices are high mainly because of Chile and Argentina and a few other countries where the capacities are high, and they are still undergoing the COVID waves, and because of that, those capacities have not come online. But do you feel that once they come online this year, the pulp prices could stabilize and come back to the earlier levels?
Janji, would like to reply?
Yes. Mehta ji, you are right. Actually, the pulp prices right now it is at very high level. Actually, it is in the hardwood pulp prices in the range of 700 and odd dollar. Earlier it used to be $450 or $470. So the pulp prices have gone up. There are various regions are there actually. There is a high demand in the China. Because of that, the prices have gone up, and some of the plants are not operating at the full capacity. So once, and the container is also one of the reason, because the container movement has got impacted substantially due to COVID. So the freight part cost has gone up. So once the corona the impacts normalize, so the pulp prices will certainly come down, because at this pulp price, Mehta ji, the ordinary the person who is depending on the imported pulp, he cannot sustain his operation economically. Hope I answered your question.
Sure, no, thank you for the detailed answer. So just one more question. If I look at your margins historically, they've been pretty volatile at the EBITDA level. So, now that we're coming up with this, new capacity, which is in packaging paper, that too in the premium segment, and also, also the headwind in terms of the pulp prices coming down and, going ahead on a normalized basis, what could be the margin trajectory?
Can you... I did not follow, actually. If you are talking about our... EBITDA margin or?
Yes, that's right. Your EBITDA margin, I'm just trying to understand what could be the future trajectory, given the fact that we're coming up with a newer capacity in the premium segment in packaging paper. So, what, and also assuming that the pulp prices, etc., they all normalize, say within a year or 2 years' time. So, what could be the, stable, steady EBITDA margin that one could work with, say 2 to 3 years, 3 to 5 years' time frame?
So, answer to your question is that we are looking at around 25% actually beta margin. If you see in 1920, we had operated at 24%. In 1819, we were at 26%. And unfortunately, for this year, we have gone down because of COVID. We were at 14%. So we hope that everything is normal, we should be able to operate within that, because we are producing the premium product actually. And I want to clarify to you that we have our own captive pulp plant and captive power plant. So the cost of production will always be lower as compared to the other industries which are depending on imported pulp actually. So we are totally insulated from the volatility of that, because right now we are not importing any pulp actually, and captively we have increased our pulp production by margin by making a investment in the debottlenecking in our pulp field. That has also helped us actually, and various initiatives a chairman has mentioned to investor members. that over a period of time, we are continuously making investment in the plant for cost reduction initiative and quality improvement. So our focus is identify the opportunity, make an investment, and that will give us a return in long term. So that has helped us to bring down our cost also and improve our efficiency and go for a marginal production increase in the existing machine also.
Makes sense. So just one thing, you know, if the pulp prices were to stay at these levels or maybe correct marginally from these levels, the EBITDA margin could be way higher than 25%, right? Because 25% you're saying is a normal scenario where the pulp prices come down to the $400 levels which they were earlier. But I'm just saying in the short term, it could ideally be much higher, much higher than the 25% range, right?
It will again depend upon the selling price, actually, which we call NSR. If the NSR goes up, so then naturally the EBITDA margin will be higher. So what we are looking at the normal scenario, so we are hopeful for that we will be able to achieve that level.
Mehtaji, I will just add a few lines to this. Again, normally we take average pulp price around the range of $6 to $60. If the $450 and $500 were also quite low, which is abnormally low price, which won't be there. So if the pulp prices are beyond $650, $750 is also very high. So whatever pulp prices are there beyond $65 will be definitely adding to extra profit of the operation of the company. So we cannot work with that mind that, okay, pulp prices will be coming as low as $500 or like this, because they were for a few months and they were abnormally low prices. That's why the pulp price has gone very high now. So we hope that normally the pulp prices should be somewhere in the range of $650. Whatever pulp prices are there, suppose $750. So with this extra pulp prices, definitely the people who are having their own pulp would be getting some reward for this.
So thank you so much. Just one last question. You had mentioned that 95% to 98% is the current captive pulp consumption. What was this a year back?
It was maybe 6-7% we were importing. 5-7% we have increased further our pulp capacity.
Okay, thanks a lot. Thank you, sir. And wish you all the best.
Okay, thank you.
Thank you. The next question is from the line of Ravindranath Naik from Sunidhi Securities. Please go ahead.
Hello. Sir, am I audible?
Yeah.
Sir, thank you for arranging this call for the investor. So again, very good number in the fourth quarter. Congratulations for that. Sir, I have... hello.
Sorry to interrupt, but there's a lot of background noise that is coming from your end.
Okay. So it is now clear?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, now it is clear.
Yeah. Sir, I actually want to my first question regarding there are a lot of policy changes after the COVID the government has initiated. So what is the outlook now you are looking at from the ASEAN imports currently when the situation normalizes?
Imports will not be much at these prices because now the international prices are also comparatively high and there is a restriction on the copier of $855. So you cannot import anything of copier, which is a big segment, below $855 because there is anti-dumping duty. Now this duty is getting over in month of December this year. We are trying, if our association is again trying with the government to have this anti-dumping duty effective after December also. So we hope that government will understand the need of the paper industry and at least the minimum support they would be giving to give a reasonable anti-dumping duty of this $855. So with this duty in place, we don't expect much import to happen in copy variety, which is a very normal variety, and same would be the same writing and printing also. So we hope that, as I was saying, that this duty support of the government would be there to the industry.
Okay. And sir, regarding this prices, can you please tell me what is the average NSR for different grades, writing, printing, copier and cup stock in Q4 and in the whole year of FY21 and FY20? So to have a like-to-like comparison, how the price has been behaved in the quarters. And also same thing you can provide me for the Andhra paper NSR, that would be helpful.
वो तो जी ऐसा है रविंद्र साहब, अब वी मे बी एबल टू सेंड यू बिकॉज दोज इन्फॉर्मेशन इन ए कैटेगरी वाइज विल नॉट बी हैविंग रेडी विद अस. एवरेज ऑफ कोर्स वी हैव, इट इज
रफली एवरेज, जस्ट अ बॉलपार्क नंबर, जस्ट गिव इट व्हाट इट वाज इन द Q4 Q3 एंड Q4, बिकॉज़ देयर आर सम प्राइस इंक्रीज हैज हैपेंड इन Q4.
सो आई थिंक जैन के पास है क्या
In a Q3, average NSR was 53,000 rupees, and you have rightly pointed out that there was an increase was there in a Q4. So the average NSR for Q4 it was 54,000. So there was a 1,000 rupees average NSR jump was there.
Okay. And similar thing for the Andhra paper, sir.
It's a more or less same pattern actually, because if you see, Ravindraji, Q1 was very good actually, Q2 came down, then again Q3 came down, and then Q4 slightly improved, and it is the same scenario across all the industries actually, particularly the paper industry.
Things are similar, the pricing situation is quite similar in this current quarter also, or it is a little bit disappointing according to you?
No, it is a more or less similar actually. Now the things have started opening up, as chairman has mentioned that things have started improving, so it is going actually.
थोड़ा सा मई में इफेक्ट आएगा, मई या 15 जून तक, 15 जून के बाद में स्टेबिलिटी हो गई है. We hope that by July 15th the prices should be again stable. To be fall hoga thoda bahut marginal fall in the month of May and June, that we will be able to make up in July September quarter.
Okay. And sir,
September quarter will be much better than the first quarter.
Okay. And sir, regarding your balance sheet, you know, there is a investment in the non-current asset category of 107 crores that is appearing in the Andhra paper's balance sheet, and also it has been consolidated. So what is that pertaining to? Any thought on that? It was earlier 18 crores in FY20, and it has gone up to 108 crores in FY21. So what is that?
I couldn't get it.
In the non-current asset category, there is a investment, other investment of 108 crores appearing in the balance sheet of Andhra paper. So what is that pertaining to?
I think it will be Rajesh, you are there.
Yes,
Rajesh,
yes,
you
yes.
Want to answer it?
Yeah, it's because we have earlier we used to invest only in securities that is maturing within a year. So this year we had invested on securities which is maturing beyond 1 year. So that has gone into that actually. We are getting better yield on those securities. All are bonds and that is a marketable bond actually.
Okay. So,
the point is this, in Andhra paper we have got surplus cash in our hand. So that investment we are doing in bond and other places. So now they are trying to have a better investment style. That's why this has come up. In Andhra paper we have got, we don't have any bank drawing. We don't have any bank credit limit on our working capital. And on the contrary, we have got some surplus cash with our hand. So it's really more than 150 crores. So that we are investing in various forms.
Yes.
Okay.
CBSE was invested in fixed deposits. So gradually return on deposits has come down on fixed deposits, and we have shifted to longer term bonds. So getting better results.
Okay.
better yield.
So in the current asset category also there is 111 crores of investments, and also this, so you mean to say these are all liquid investments which can be available for this capital expenditure if at all anything you plan to do.
Absolutely.
Okay, so 200 crores is still free cash available with under paper currently.
Under paper is sitting on a cash of roughly 200 crores.
Okay. And sir, is there any plan for the demerger of the telecom business, or is there any, there is no plan at all?
Immediately, we are not having any planning. There were some technical hitches coming, some costs were coming, and it will be also affecting our telecom business. So we have got one land now in Hyderabad. We are going for one backward integration in Hyderabad for our this pulp, for our this cable plant. So once we take up this project, then we will be planning. Before that, there were some technical hitches coming for our demerger.
Okay, okay. So what is the total quantum you are planning to invest in telecom business at all?
It will be roughly 100 crores. It's a total scheme of 120 crores. And in that we will be, because this is in the telecom sector and government is giving lot of push, so we will be getting a benefit of a subsidy in that of roughly 30 crores. So net investment will be coming 90 crores after this 30 crores subsidy. This subsidy is from central government, 20 crores and 10 crores from the state government. So taking all together, 30 crores subsidy we will be getting in this investment of 120 crores. So net will be, as I was saying, it will be 90 crores.
Okay. So these are predominantly optical fiber cable, or it is something, a telecom equipment?
No. This is not optical fiber cable. We are making optical fiber cable in our Mysore plant. Here we will be making the fiber itself.
Okay.
This is a backward integration where we plan to make fiber.
Some
high grade fiber for optical fiber cable.
Okay. And sir, one thing, you know, you have said that we are planning going for expansion in the packaging board. Sir, I have a few observations, because you are sitting with the adequate pulp capacity in Andhra paper facility, because I understand that Andhra paper has got adequate pulp capacity, plus with because they have invested a lot in the contract farming, so they have a wood facility also, the wood availability is also good. Why the company did not plan an expansion in Andhra paper, because it is sitting with the cash? And why we are taking an initiative in West Coast paper?
देखिए ऐसा है कि you know that we took over Andhra paper only 1.5 years before.
Okay.
We took somewhere in November, and from March the lockdown started. So ये जो 1.5 साल का period गया है, we couldn't do anything in Andhra paper. Now we have started working on this. Andhra paper, there is no extra pulp capacity now in Andhra paper. There is raw material availability is comparatively easier. Cost of raw material is also low, but our pulp capacity is fully used. We don't have any extra capacity. Now, after our taking over, we have started working on the Andhra paper upgradation. And we are now trying to improve our pulp capacity further. Now we have got a pulp capacity of 550 tons, and we are planning to make 150 tons more in Andhra paper by upgradation. So this system we have started, but as I was saying, because of the COVID, we couldn't take it up speedily. We hope that in 2-3 months time, we will take it up. And then we will be further improving our pulp capacity. The present capacity of the pulp is not 100% sufficient to feed our paper unit. Even now we are using waste paper to make full raw material requirement. So we require further pulp capacity to support our paper production.
Okay.
So we have already started planning for this, and I think maybe in 3-4 months time we will be placing the order for this.
Okay. So what is the total pulp capacity at Andhra paper, sir? The virgin pulp capacity and 170
will be 550 tons into 30, roughly it will be 160,000 tons like this.
Okay. And also we are simultaneously recycled pulp capacity.
Was separate. That is separate. We have got waste paper capacity also of pulp. That is separate. So this is the wood capacity of pulp, and this waste paper capacity of pulp is separate. So that will be again, I think, 150 tons like this.
Okay. Sir, you mentioned that you are also manufacturing a duplex board. You are manufacturing this duplex board of West Coast paper or it Andhra paper?
Only in West Coast.
Okay. Thank you very much, sir. All the best. Thank you.
Thank you. The next question is from the line of Saket Kapoor from Kapoor & Company. Please go ahead.
Namaskar, sir. Jain sahab aur Bangarji, namaskar. धन्यवाद सर इस अपॉर्चुनिटी के लिए सर सर फर्स्टली सर ये वेस्ट सेटलमेंट का कोई इशू था हैज देयर बीन एनी मैंने इंक्रीमेंटल वेजेस दैट विल बी गेट इंप्लीमेंटेड फॉर द नेक्स्ट ईयर वन एंड हाउ डू द एम्प्लॉय व्हाट इज द एम्प्लॉय कॉस्ट गोइंग टू लुक लाइक
कपूर साहब अपने वेस्ट कोस्ट में वेस्ट सेटलमेंट अभी ड्यू है एक्चुअली ये 1st जनवरी 2019 से है और ये 4 ईयर का होता है हमारा तो इसमें परमानेंट वर्कमैन इनको इंक्रीज दिया जाता है एक सूटेबल इंक्रीज हम लोग कंसीडर करते हैं हम लोगों ने ऑलरेडी अपना जो प्रॉफिट एंड लॉस अकाउंट है उसमें जो लास्ट टाइम पे हमने जो इंक्रीज दिया है वो सेटलमेंट में और प्लस मार्जिनली जो भी कुछ करेक्शन हमको लगता है कि होगा उसमें वो देख के हमने प्रोवाइड कर दिया है सो आपका क्वेश्चन है कि ये इसका क्या इम्पैक्ट आएगा
yes, sir. जी सर
आगे कुछ भी इम्पैक्ट नहीं आएगा ऑलरेडी अपने प्रोवाइड किया हुआ है
अच्छा.
तो ये एक्चुअली ये क्या कोविड के कारण ये सारा डिले हो गया और अभी भी हमारा नेगोशिएशन चल रहा है एंड वी आर होपफुल कि ये जल्दी से जल्दी हो जाए तो वो उसके बाद फिर उनको पेमेंट कर देंगे अपन
अच्छा मैंने जो आपका बैलेंस शीट में जो प्रोविजन की कैटेगरी है उसके अंदर ये फिगर ऑलरेडी प्रोवाइड फॉर किया हुआ है प्रोविजन के अकाउंट में खड़ा हुआ
ओके हाँ जी कपूर साहब किया हुआ
ओके सर सेकेंडली सर रॉ मटेरियल की जो हमारी बास्केट है पल्प हुआ फिर आपके वुड्स हुए उसकी प्राइसिंग वुड चिप्स एंड ऑल की हाउ इज दैट लुकिंग लाइक उसमें हम लोग सोर्सिंग कैसे करते हैं सर
कपूर साहब आपको एक चीज बताना चाहूंगा कि ओवर ए पीरियड ऑफ टाइम हम लोगों ने जो कॉस्टली इंपोर्टेड चिप्स हुआ करता था जो पहले हम लोग यहाँ प्लांट में कंज्यूम करते थे वो हमने जीरो कर दिया है पहले बिगनिंग में हमारा आई एम टॉकिंग अबाउट 4-5 ईयर्स बैक जब हम लोग करीब 50-60% इम्पोर्टेड चिप्स यूज करते थे एंड वी यूज टू इम्पोर्ट फ्रॉम साउथ अफ्रीका हमने प्लांट में ऑप्टिमाइजेशन किया कैपेक्स इन्वेस्ट प्रोसेस को ऑप्टिमाइज किया कैपेक्स मोर देन 100 करोड़ रुपीज के करीब हमने पल्प मिल में इन्वेस्टमेंट किया ओवर पीरियड ऑफ टाइम तो वो इम्पोर्टेड चिप्स हटा दिया उससे हमारी रॉ मटेरियल की कॉस्ट सिग्निफिकेंटली कम हुई फिर साथ में दूसरे जो इनपुट रेशियो है जो केमिकल्स लगते हैं अपने प्रोसेस में उसको हमने बहुत टेक्निकल ऑडिट्स करा के हम लोग क्या टेक्निकल ऑडिट जो है ओईएम्स जो है जैसे आज वालमेट है दे आर द वर्ल्ड लीडर एक्चुअली उन्हीं को इंगेज करते हैं और उन्हीं से पूरा आइडिया लेते हैं कि कहाँ हमारी अपॉर्चुनिटीज फॉर इम्प्रूवमेंट है और वो होने के बाद हमने प्लांट में ब्लीचिंग सेक्शन में आज जैसे इम्प्रूवमेंट किया हमारा वॉशिंग सेक्शन में इम्प्रूवमेंट किया नया वॉशिंग प्रेस लगाया कुकिंग में हमको एडिशनल डाइजेस्टर मिलने लग गया तो इससे क्या हमारी की जो टोटल कॉस्ट ऑफ प्रोडक्शन है वो मतलब कंटिन्यूसली हम कम कर पा रहे हैं इम्प्रूव कर पा रहे हैं रॉ मटेरियल की अवेलेबिलिटी नॉर्मल है जो मार्केट में आज इसे डीजल इंक्रीज होता है या फार्मर की एक्सपेक्टेशन होती है वो इंक्रीज हमारे को टाइम टू टाइम देना पड़ता है
नहीं सर जैसे हम लोग देखते हैं कॉस्ट ऑफ मटेरियल कंज्यूम एंड पावर फ्यूल एंड वाटर ये दो मेजर एक्सपेंसेस आपके हैं पीएनएल में तो अगर कॉस्ट ऑफ मटेरियल कंज्यूम में जाएंगे तो इसमें पल्प का अगर आप मुझे स्प्लिटअप दें सर इसका कॉस्ट ऑफ मटेरियल में क्या मेजर परसेंटेज है केमिकल कितना है और पल्प का क्या कंट्रीब्यूशन है
इसमें मेन तो क्या है कि सर, अभी आप रॉ मटेरियल की जो बात कर रहे हैं तो मेन क्या होता है, वुड आएगा एक, तो जो बिग टिकट आइटम जो है वुड है, उसके बाद में केमिकल्स जो है उसको प्रोसेसिंग के लिए जो लगते हैं पल्प बनाने के लिए वो लगेंगे, फिर उसके बाद जो पल्प बनने के बाद अपने को पेपर बनाने के लिए जो केमिकल वो लगेंगे, तो वो अलग अलग हेड में है अपने उस हिसाब से रहता है।
अच्छा, तो मैंने कॉस्ट ऑफ मटेरियल कंज्यूम का जो हेड है सर उसके अंदर, मैंने इफ यू कुड प्रोवाइड डिटेल ऑफ दैट, व्हाट कॉन्स्टिट्यूट द कॉस्ट ऑफ मटेरियल कंज्यूम, इट इंक्लूड्स ऑल ऑफ देम।
हाँ जी, हाँ जी, मैं आपको वही कपूर साहब, मैं आपको वही बता रहा हूँ कि तो जैसे मतलब वो क्या है कि मैं आपको वही बताया कि जैसे मेरा आज इसमें लकड़ी का आ गया है कॉस्ट जैसे 385 crores मेरा टोटल मिला के जो है वुड अकाउंट में आया है, मतलब वो बहुत सारे हेड रहते हैं ना सर। Okay. आज केमिकल कंजम्पशन आया है, वो उसका इंसिडेंट आ गया है, तो इस हिसाब से ये रहेगा सर।
सर केमिकल्स हेड में हमारे कॉस्टिक सोडा की हाइड्रोजन पेरोक्साइड दोनों का ही कंजम्पशन रहता है सर, किसी हाइड्रोजन पेरोक्साइड की यूटिलाइजेशन रहती है?
मतलब दो के अलावा और केमिकल्स रहते हैं एक्चुअली, सल्फ्यूरिक एसिड भी रहेगा, बर्नट लाइम भी रहेगा, दूसरे हम लोग स्टार्च कंज्यूम करते हैं, ऑप्टिकल ब्राइटनिंग एजेंट यूज करते हैं, तो ये मेजर केमिकल्स की बात कर रहा हूँ मैं आपको।
और सर सर अगर हम लोग वैल्यू एडेड प्रोडक्ट्स के बारे में बात करें तो व्हाट परसेंटेज ऑफ द टोटल सेल्स आर टुवर्ड्स द वैल्यू एडेड एंड व्हाट स्टेप्स आर वी टेकिंग टू इम्प्रूव दैट मिक्स सर?
एक्चुअली सर अगर आप देखें कि हम लोगों की जो प्रोडक्ट प्रोफाइल है उसमें हम लोगों ने ओवर ए पीरियड ऑफ टाइम मार्केटिंग टीम और प्लांट टीम के साथ मिलके हम कंटिन्यूसली वैल्यू एडेड प्रोडक्ट के ऊपर ज़्यादा फोकस कर रहे हैं। एक हमारी कंपनी में एक एडवांटेज एक ये है कि हमारी छोटी मशीनें हैं, तो छोटी मशीनों में हम हमारे कस्टमर को छोटा जो है क्वांटिटी फुलफिल कर पाते हैं और एक नया वैल्यू एडेड प्रोडक्ट उसको दे पाते हैं। तो ओवर ए पीरियड ऑफ टाइम ने बहुत सारे प्रोडक्ट इसमें किए हैं। आज जैसे अगर आप देखें कि जो स्ट्रा रहती है अपनी, बेनिंग ऑफ प्लास्टिक का जब आया स्ट्रा को, ये पेपर उसके लिए पेपर हमने यहाँ हमारे यहाँ टीम ने वर्क करके बनाया। फिर ये जो कप रहते हैं अपने, कप स्टॉक्स जो रहते हैं वो हमने यहाँ बनाया, और अभी जैसे हम लोग ने 300 GSM का पेपर हमारी मशीन के ऊपर एक्सपेरिमेंट करके बनाया है। तो हमारी क्या है कि ये पुरानी मशीन है, बट व्हाट वी आर डूइंग कि ओवर पीरियड ऑफ टाइम उसमें कंटिन्यूसली इन्वेस्टमेंट कर रहे हैं ताकि क्वालिटी इम्प्रूवमेंट करें। मैं कपूर साहब आपको बताना चाहूँगा कि जैसे आज हमारे लोगों की एक PM3 जो मशीन थी वो उसमें नॉन सरफेस साइज मशीन थी, तो उसको 3 साल पहले चेयरमैन सर ने अप्रूव किया, 60 करोड़ रुपीज़ का हमने इन्वेस्टमेंट किया उसमें, सरफेस साइज मशीन बनाया, और उसके बाद उसकी क्वालिटी में इतना सिग्निफिकेंट सुधार हुआ है, और उसमें बल्क जो है जो आज नोटबुक में जाता है वो बड़ा अच्छा बल्क है उसका, तो वो बड़ा एक अच्छा रियलाइजेशन हमारे को मिला और बड़ा अच्छा प्रोडक्ट हम मार्केट में दे पाए। तो कंटिन्यूसली आज हर एक मशीन के ऊपर कोशिश यही कर रहे हैं हम लोग कि एक तो वैल्यू एडेड प्रोडक्ट बनाया जाए और दूसरा उसमें टाइमली इन्वेस्टमेंट किया जाए, मतलब वो सबसे कपूर साहब क्या है कि आप जब तक वो फोकस नहीं आएगा, इन्वेस्टमेंट आप नहीं करोगे तो आपका वो नहीं आ पाएगा। तो वो सिमिलरली हम लोग इन्वेस्टमेंट पल्प प्रोडक्शन के ऊपर भी पल्प क्वालिटी के ऊपर भी करते हैं। आज पल्प की जो आज कागज अगर आप बना रहे हो उसमें हाई स्ट्रेंथ अगर आपकी डेवलप करनी है तो आपका पल्प में स्ट्रेंथ होनी है, तो हम लोग ने पीछे पल्प का जो प्रोडक्शन प्रोसेस है उसको ऑप्टिमाइज किया है, तो उससे स्ट्रेंथ हमारी इंप्रूवमेंट, जो पहले जो विस्कोसिटी हमारी 8 आती थी तो अभी 9.5 आई है, तो ये सब अभी ऑफलेट सब लोगों ने इन्वेस्टमेंट किए उनका बेनिफिट आया है। कपूर साहब, आई होप आई आंसर्ड योर क्वेश्चन।
यस सर, ओनली लास्ट 2 पॉइंट्स, कैपेसिटी यूटिलाइजेशन कैसे थे हमारे फोर्थ क्वार्टर में, और पूरे ईयर में तो सर डेफिनेटली लोअर साइड पे काफी होंगे, बट फॉर द फोर्थ क्वार्टर आई थिंक इट वाज अ नॉर्मल क्वार्टर इन सम सेंस, तो क्या यूटिलाइजेशन लेवल थे सर व्हेन 81,000 का आपने?
हाँ कपूर साहब, आपका अच्छा क्वेश्चन है। कैपेसिटी यूटिलाइजेशन फोर्थ क्वार्टर में 102% था अपना.
अच्छा.
मतलब पूरी पूरा मही आई विल टेल यू कपूर साहब कि फोर्थ क्वार्टर इज अ फैंटास्टिक क्वार्टर. 102% पे अपना प्लांट चला और सारी मशीनें नॉन स्टॉप चली और सुपीरियर क्वालिटी और प्लांट में वर्किंग भी इट वाज अ फैंटास्टिक वर्किंग एक्चुअली.
But that will be down significantly for this quarter in the sub 50 levels because of lockdown and all.
हाँ जी सेकेंड वेव का इम्पैक्ट तो आएगा ही ना सब. अब ये सेकेंड वेव में केसेस कम हो गए हैं नाउ. सारा जो ओपनिंग का अभी आ रहा है सो नाउ थिंग्स स्टार्टेड इंप्रूविंग एक्चुअली जैसे चेयरमैन सर ने बताया आपको.
तो बॉल पास कैसा देख रहे हैं यूटिलाइजेशन लेवल्स इस करंट क्वार्टर के लिए और रैंपिंग अप कैसा देख रहे हैं आगे के लिए? एक बॉल पास नंबर अगर आप शेयर करना चाहें.
एक्चुअली हम लोग का देखिए हम लोगों का टारगेट यही है कि मैक्सिमम इसको किया जाए और हम लोगों के पास सफिशिएंट स्टोरेज कैपेसिटी है. सो वी डोंट एक्सपेक्ट एनीथिंग कि मार्केट में अभी थोड़ा बहुत हो सकता है कि डिमांड कोई इम्पैक्ट हो लेकिन एक कपूर साहब आप एक बेसिक फंडामेंटल आप समझने का कोशिश करिए. इंडिया में पेपर का कंजम्पशन ओनली 15 kg है ना साहब और वर्ल्ड में 57 kg है पर कैपिटा की मैं बात कर रहा हूँ साहब आपको. और दूसरा मैं बता रहा हूँ कि आपने अगर ये इस साल का बजट भी अगर देखें एजुकेशन सेक्टर में गवर्नमेंट ऑफ इंडिया ने जो एजुकेशन सेक्टर के लिए एलोकेट किया है 93,000 crore rupees. ठीक है वो इम्पैक्ट हो गया है इसमें स्कूल एजुकेशन के लिए सिग्निफिकेंट अमाउंट है हायर एजुकेशन. तब आप देखिए कि राष्ट्रीय उच्चतर शिक्षा अभियान सर्व शिक्षा अभियान बेटी बचाओ पढ़ाओ राइट टू एजुकेशन राष्ट्रीय माध्यमिक शिक्षा अभियान मतलब इतने सारे सरकार जो फोकस कर रही है तो पेपर इंडस्ट्री का तो ऑलवेज फ्यूचर ब्राइट है सर. मेरा आपसे यही कहना है अपना तो कोशिश ये रहेगा कि ऑलवेज हाईएस्ट प्रोडक्शन बनाए क्योंकि डिमांड तो पेपर की इंडिया में इतनी कम है और आने वाले समय में बढ़ने वाली है तो ये तो एक टेम्परेरी इशू आ गया है.
ये न्यू एजुकेशन पॉलिसी का भी बेनिफिट रहेगा सर जब आगे इंप्लीमेंट होंगे तो उसकी भी एक इंक्रीमेंटल डिमांड बनेगी.
जी कपूर साहब सही बोल रहे हैं एक्चुअली. तो वो सारा ये मतलब पेपर तो क्या इससे नेसेसिटी आइटम एक्चुअली. और अभी जो सो कॉल्ड इवन डिजिटल की बात किया है ये सब इसका क्या है इतने एडवर्स इम्पैक्ट है. आपका भी अगर बच्चा है तो आज वो डिजिटल में पढ़ना कितना उसको इनकन्वीनियंट हो रहा है बट वी सिंस वी डू नॉट हैव अ चॉइस तो ये इसको एक्सेप्ट कर रहे हैं बट थिंग्स विल चेंज.
फाइनेंस कॉस्ट अभी क्या है सर हमारा व्हाट इज अवर लॉन्ग टर्म फाइनेंस कॉस्ट एंड वर्किंग कैपिटल रिक्वायरमेंट का क्या कॉस्ट है ब्लेंडेड कॉस्ट कितना है?
राजेश विल यू लाइक टू एक्सप्लेन दैट?
ये है हमारा कि टर्म लोन जो है टर्म लोन हम लोग रुपए टर्म लोन था करीब कुछ 10.3 का भी है और कुछ हम लोग फॉरेन करेंसी लिए हैं जिसको हेज करवाए थे कुछ टर्म लोन को हम लोग स्वाप कराए हैं. इस तरह से हम लोग कॉस्ट काफ़ी एवरेज कॉस्ट काफ़ी डाउन किया था और वर्किंग कैपिटल भी हम लोग ज़्यादातर WCDL और कमर्शियल पेपर के थ्रू से सीसी का
रेट ब्लेंडेड कॉस्ट बताएंगे सर क्या ब्लेंडेड कॉस्ट
बता दूँ ना 8.5% के करीब आया हुआ है 8.5%
दिस इज इंक्लूडिंग द वर्किंग कैपिटल आल्सो.
यस
ओके एंड आवर डेट लेवल इज 400
मिस्टर कपूर.
यस सर
सॉरी टू इंटरप्ट यू इफ वी कैन जस्ट गिव अदर पार्टिसिपेंट्स एन अपॉर्चुनिटी.
यस सर आई विल कम इन द क्यू
वी विल कम बैक टू यू टाइम परमिटिंग.
एब्सोल्युटली सर. यस सर
एंड पार्टिसिपेंट्स आर रिक्वेस्टेड टू लिमिट देमसेल्व्स टू 2 questions एंड गिव अदर पार्टिसिपेंट्स एन अपॉर्चुनिटी टाइम परमिटिंग वी विल गेट बैक टू यू. Steven, please go ahead.
Thank you. The next question is from the line of Nikhil from Oswal Investment. Please go ahead.
Hello. Congratulations, sir, for a good set of numbers. See, my question primarily was around the gross margins. See, what you're saying that for West Coast, majority pulp is in-house. So in that case, sir, why have your gross margins come down from around 49-50% in last quarter to in Q4.
निखिल जी, आप ग्रॉस मार्जिन में क्या हिसाब से आप ले रहे हैं?
सर ग्रॉस मार्जिन खाली
मैं अगर मैं मेरा जो सिंपल आपको एक जो हम लोग जो देखते हैं इबीटा मार्जिन जो है इफ यू सी निखिल जी मेरा क्वार्टर थ्री का जो है एक्चुअली इट वाज 13%, नाउ इट हैज गोन अप टू 18%. इसमें क्या यू आर राइट, हम लोग का कैप्टिव पल्प का पूरा अरेंजमेंट है, लेकिन व्हेन प्रोडक्शन इज नॉट हैपनिंग ड्यू टू द कोविड रिस्ट्रिक्शन, प्लांट बंद करके बैठे हुए थे अपन, विच आर हैपनिंग एवरीवेयर, तो उसके कारण वो इम्पैक्ट आया. वंस द थिंग स्टार्टेड गोइंग इन द राइट डायरेक्शन, सो फ्रॉम 13% इट हैज गोन टू 18%, मेरा वो कहना है.
नहीं सर, नहीं सर, आई गॉट योर पॉइंट ऑन एबिटा. मैं क्या बोल रहा हूँ, मैं ग्रॉस मार्जिन में खाली कॉस्ट ऑफ मटेरियल कंज्यूम और अपना चेंज इन इन्वेंट्रीज ले रहा हूँ लास्ट दो क्वार्टर का, अगर आप देखें तो दैट इज माई ग्रॉस मार्जिन लेवल. अदर कॉस्ट कैन कम डाउन लेटर, दैट्स ओके. तो ऑन दैट लेवल वाई हैव, बिकॉज द प्रोडक्शन हैव ऑल गुड ऑन इन दिस क्यू फोर, एंड इनफैक्ट माई देर शुड बी सम बेनिफिट्स ऑफ इकोनॉमीज ऑफ स्केल, राइट? तो इनफैक्ट कम होना चाहिए. एंड आई वॉज चेकिंग अदर कंपनीज, इवन उनका ग्रॉस मार्जिन लेवल्स आर अराउंड 50% फॉर क्यू4, सो व्हाई हैव आर मार्जिन्स कम डाउन? मतलब कुछ इंक्रीज, मतलब कुछ वन ऑफ इंपैक्ट हुआ है या व्हाट इज दैट? आई जस्ट वांटेड टू अंडरस्टैंड.
आई जस्ट वांट टू क्लेरिफाई कि देयर इज नो वन ऑफ इंपैक्ट एक्चुअली. अब आप नंबर्स की जो बात कर रहे हैं, क्योंकि हम लोग ग्रॉस मार्जिन टर्म्स में ऐसा मैंने कैलकुलेशन चेक नहीं किया है, बट देयर इज नो रीजन एक्चुअली. ओनली एक रीजन जो हो सकता है, मैं आपको क्लेरिफाई करना चाहूंगा निखिल जी, कि हम लोगों ने क्या किया था कि क्वार्टर थ्री का जो पार्ट था, हो सकता वो ऑब्जर्वेशन आपका सही हो, क्वार्टर थ्री में हम लोगों ने हमारे रिकवरी बॉयलर का शटडाउन लिया. बिकॉज क्या हो रहा था कि सिंस देयर वाज नो देयर वाज अ वेरी लो डिमांड ड्यू टू कोरोना, सो वी डिसाइडेड टू टेक अ मेजर शट ऑफ आवर रिकवरी बॉयलर फॉर 45 days for replacing the some tubes and for ESP modifications and all those things which we did actually. So that was a right decision for utilizing the time. And in that process what happened, like since we our because our recovery boiler was down, so we were not able to run our pulp mill at a full capacity. So in order to run the mill paper machines, we purchased some pulp from outside market actually. So that may be the impact actually. Otherwise, with the captive pulp, everything is in in a better shape actually.
Okay. So normalized, this may be this quarter hua hai, but maybe going forward again that will come back to normal level.
जी हाँ निखिल जी.
ओके सर, थैंक यू.
थैंक यू. वी टेक द नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन फ्रॉम द लाइन ऑफ रिदिशा, एन इंडिविजुअल इन्वेस्टर, प्लीज गो अहेड.
हेलो सर, थैंक यू. सो आई एक्चुअली मेनी ऑफ माय क्वेश्चंस हैव बीन आंसर्ड, बट आई वांटेड टू अंडरस्टैंड, सो द ग्रॉस मार्जिन्स इज द प्रीवियस पार्टिसिपेंट वाज सेइंग, It is also because your realizations have come down, right? From 61,000 to 54,000.
Yeah, Priti ji, you are right actually what you are saying, because during that time the quarter three impact was there. The realizations have come down. And as I explained to you, in quarter four it has increased. Because again, it depends on the market condition. And at the same time, we were able to run our plant at a 101% capacity, actually.
Okay. And sir, so primarily you are into printing and writing paper production, right? There is no packaging board production as of now. Is that right?
Yeah, 30% will be writing and printing.
हाँ
जी बताइए.
नहीं, मैं आपका वही क्वेश्चन बता रहा था कि राइटिंग प्रिंटिंग का प्रोडक्शन कम हुआ, इट्स मेनली बिकॉज ऑफ द स्कूल्स एंड कॉलेजेस एंड देन वर्किंग फ्रॉम होम दैट हैपेंड एक्चुअली. this is also once in 100 years it has happened. Actually, nobody thought about that happening. Nobody thought that COVID will come in such a big manner, actually. So because of that, this writing printing has got impacted, actually.
Okay. So the 320,000 tons capacity is 30% into printing and writing, 30% copier, and the remaining that cup, plastic-free coated cup and everything. Is that right?
Yeah, you are right.
Okay. And Andhra Paper is also into printing and writing, entire capacity.
Yeah, same.
Okay. And one more question. So I was going through the annual report and I read of FY20. So it is saying that you have fully completed your pilot project in the optical cable business, and now you can take up large projects. So should we expect some growth in the revenues from there, or how should we see it?
What is your question, I think?
No, I'm not able
to understand. Couldn't you
have the question? I'll rephrase. So optical cable business is revenues are 100 crore, right? On an average. Yeah. So should we expect any increase there or growth? What are the growth prospects?
Of course, there would be some growth. Yeah, again, COVID has affected the laying of the cable. So there were cable demand was also low. Some normalcy coming, maybe this year would be definitely better than the last year. Normally, the production will be expecting maybe in the range of 140 to 150 crores.
Okay. Thank you. Yeah, all the best.
Yeah. Yeah.
Thank you, Priti ji.
Yeah.
Thank you. The next question. Ladies and gentlemen, due to time constraint, we take that as the last question. I now hand the conference over to Mr. Jain for his closing remarks. Over to you, sir.
Thank you, Naveenji. My esteemed investors, and thank you very much for your all the interest in WCPM. And friends, I want to tell you that this year, due to the COVID, things have got impacted. Otherwise, your company is doing exceedingly well. And in our plant, the whole focus is there to produce a quality product. And we want to become the most preferred supplier. And at the same time, continuously, we are focusing for bringing down the cost. And for that, the continuous investments are being made. And we take the help of experts in various fields, actually, in the raw material front, that's a pulp mill area, in the recovery side, in energy side, we take the help of Forbes Marshalls or those other energy experts, actually. And we get the audit done from these people, and then we implement from time to time. So our focus is there. Whatever losses which are there, we have to minimize at the source level. So the basic thinking is that the end of the pipe treatment concept has to go. And at the same time, our focus is there that our environment footprint we want to improve significantly, and we are working and we are complying with all environment laws. And cost reduction part, I mentioned you, quality I mentioned you, and at the same time improving the production efficiency by marginal investment that we are focusing, actually. And as Chairman Sir has already mentioned that we are planning for a future expansion. It's a 40% capacity increase, actually, from 320,000 ton to actually it's going to 450,000 ton. So we will be going for a value-added products in that machine, actually. So things are going on. So we hope the things should come in shape after some time. That's all. And with even and we have been a continuous dividend paying company in spite of the difficult situation this year. Still we have considered the dividend. Our board of directors have considered the dividend for our investors. I know the expectation will always be higher, but things will improve. That's what I want to tell to all my friends, investors who have reposed the confidence in West Coast, SK Bangur Group. Thank you very much.
Thank you. Ladies and gentlemen, on behalf of SKP Securities Limited, that concludes this conference. Thank you for joining us. Ladies and gentlemen, you may now disconnect your lines.
Okay, thank you.
Thank you.